I'd now like to take a few moments to appreciate and acknowledge the legacy of Qira'a in South Africa. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had distinguished a few individuals amongst the Sahaba radiallahu anhum who had excelled in the recital of the Qur'an Majeed and the various Qira'at. The likes of Ubay ibn Ka'ab and Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhuma. Subsequently, the Imams of Qira'a, they traced their legacy back to these respective Sahaba. After them, their Ruwat, meaning those who transmitted the Qira'a from them, became the Madar of different regions within the Islamic world. Madar meaning they became responsible for popularizing that specific Qira'a in that certain region. Likewise, our Madar in South Africa is none other than Qari Ayyub Ishaq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praising the Sahaba radiallahu anhum in the Qur'an Majeed, he draws a parallel between a farmer and the likes of the Sahaba. كَزَرْعٍ أَخْرَجَ شَطْأَهُ فَآزَرَهُ فَاسْتَغْلَظَ فَاسْتَوَى عَلَى سُوقِهِ يُعْجِبُ الزُّرَّاعَ لِيَغِيظَ بِهِمُ الْكُفَّارِ. How a farmer plants a seed and then there's a sprout, and eventually you have a fully grown tree that is deeply rooted in the ground. Likewise, in the 80s, Qari Ayyub, hafidhahullah, returned from India to a barren South Africa, a land that didn't know about Qira'a. There was no Qurra in South Africa. And that was in the 80s. Now 30 years later, the student of Qari Ayyub's students are finishing Qira'a. So this is our legacy of Qira'a in South Africa. The most prestigious lineage amongst the Sahaba radiallahu anhum was the lineage of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhum. And that is because Abu Bakr radiallahu anhum accepted Islam on the hands of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His father Abu Quhafa accepted Islam at the hands of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His son Abdul Rahman also accepted Islam at the hands of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And his grandson, Muhammad, also accepted Islam at the hands of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Four links. And I can assure you, not just in South Africa, but throughout the world, not just the students of Qari Ayyub are teaching Qira'a, but rather the students of his students are also engaged in teaching Qira'a. This is our legacy, and this is our father, Shaykh al-Qurra, al-Muqri, Ayyub Ishaq. I now call upon Qari Sahab to address us all.